In this video, we're going to talk about why people blame you for everything and how you can quickly identify these kinds of people. I'll also be talking about how your psychology could cause you to consistently choose partners that treat you this way. So stick around for that. When a person doesn't get enough love, support, or attention as a child for being their true natural selves, they tend to adopt an alternate way of behaving in order to get the attention they need. The two most common categories are the internalizers that become accepting, accommodating, and self-sacrificing in the hopes that it will make people love and accept them, and the externalizers that impulsively act out in order to make people pay attention to them. If it feels like people blame you for everything, there's a good chance that you are an internalizer and you're dealing with externalizers. To start, let's look at the traits of externalizers. At their core, they believe that their problems are the fault of other people, and so they're constantly looking to blame others for the things that are going on in their lives. One of the biggest clues is they tend to be impulsive. They don't think things through, but instead respond quickly to situations. They underestimate the difficulty, get mad easily when things don't go their way, and expect others to help them when they get in trouble. In a relationship, they tend to view all criticism as nagging, expect others to listen to their problems without them being a good listener in return, and think that their partner should do all the changing whenever there's problems in the relationship. In contrast, internalizers tend to think that if something went wrong, they might be to blame. They look inwardly to think what they might have done better or how they might have caused the situation with their behavior. Internalizers think before acting and so are much less impulsive. All this thinking can cause them to worry about the future and overestimate the difficulty of the situations they encounter. They tend to be self-reflective and take responsibility when things go wrong. They often find the study of psychology to be very interesting and can be made to easily feel guilty. In relationships, they tend to focus on the needs of their partner. They're more than willing to discuss problems and listen to what their partner has to say, and they tend to think about how they might change or alter their behavior in order to improve the situation. It is possible for externalizers to be more self-reflective when they hit rock bottom, and internalizers can lash out when they're very stressed, but overall look for the most common behavioral patterns to figure out what you're dealing with. If you're watching this video, you're more likely to be an internalizer than an externalizer because internalizers tend to want to understand people and learn how they operate. With that in mind, the rest of this video will talk about what it's like to be an internalizer, and the next video will talk about how to find an emotionally balanced partner so that you can have a healthy relationship where you're not constantly being blamed for everything. Internalizers are very perceptive. They tend to know how other people are feeling because they've learned to alter their behavior in order to meet the needs of others. Internalizers often feel isolated or lonely, but have a strong desire to connect with others and feel loved. They tend to fear relying on others too heavily because people have failed to be there for them in the past, so they may be cautious in forming new connections. Since internalizers were not able to get their needs met from their family, it's not uncommon for them to have some sort of outside connection, like a close friend or an adult in the neighborhood that provided them with a connection and support they couldn't get at home. While an externalizer will demand that people help them, internalizers are cautious about asking for help because they don't think anyone cares enough to help them or that they're not worthy of getting help to begin with. It's very easy for internalizers to be neglected. They tend to focus on the needs of the other people in their life and rarely bring up their own. Since internalizers find dealing with externalizers to be very familiar, they tend to form relationships with these externalizers, causing it to be very easy for their needs to be neglected. This familiarity with neglect is actually a real problem. I mentioned at the beginning of the video that your psychology might be causing you to choose partners that blame everything on you. This is familiarity at work. We tend to look for relationships that are familiar to what we experienced in the past. If our childhood was filled with neglect and blame, we look for partners that are neglectful. In fact, it may even be so bad that when you meet somebody that is considerate and kind to you, you just think of them as boring. I'll go deeper into this in the next video on finding a good, emotionally mature partner, so keep watching. And if you're finding this video helpful, make sure you give it a like and subscribe to the channel. It's not uncommon for internalizers to describe themselves as invisible. Because they get so little positive attention, they often feel a deep sense of gratitude when someone finally appreciates them. Internalizers learn to ignore their own feelings and often become overly independent. When you can't count on other people to be there for you, you learn to take care of yourself. Internalizers tend to be the backbone of romantic relationships, doing most of the work to keep the relationship going. Because they're so used to being ignored and taken for granted, they often don't even notice when they're in an abusive relationship. When around depressed people, some internalizers will adopt a cheery disposition to compensate. They also tend to attract needy people, since they're so used to doing things for others that needy people recognize them as the kind of person that'll help them out. Perhaps the most damaging trait of internalizers is they tend to think they can make someone love them by neglecting their own needs and focusing entirely on their partner. The big problem here is they usually don't express their own needs, and they're not being their true selves, so their partner can't be there for them even if they want to be. Hiding your true self and hiding your needs will not get people to love you, and it's an extremely ineffective way to get your needs met. I myself grew up to be an internalizer. When I was young, I used to call myself a personality chameleon because I could change my personality to adapt to whoever I was with. At the time, I thought this was a great thing because I could fit in anywhere. It wasn't until later that I realized I didn't feel free to be my true self because I didn't think people would accept me. I also naturally take responsibility for everything. In some ways, this is positive because every mistake is an opportunity to learn, grow, and improve. But it has the downside that it's very easy to find yourself in an abusive relationship and have your needs neglected. When I started my personal growth project to perfect charisma, part of it was learning to be accepted as my true self and not always cater to the needs of others. This is a powerful skill that contributed greatly to my self-confidence. If this is something you think you would benefit from, you might want to check out the Social Skills Mastery online training program that's linked in the description below. It focuses heavily on developing self-confidence and self-esteem, along with all the skills you need to deal with people to get everything you want from life. Plus, there's an entire online community to help you in your journey. And if you want more information on how people become internalizers and externalizers, and how to break free of these behavior patterns, I recommend the book Adult Children of Emotionally Immature Parents by Lindsay Gibbons. It goes into great detail about how the way parents treat their children can cause these kinds of behaviors and how you can respond to them. So check out the Amazon link below if you're interested. In the next video, we'll talk about the qualities of a good, emotionally mature relationship partner so that you can be sure that your next relationship is with someone that treats you well and doesn't take advantage of you. So stay tuned.